Hello, everyone, and welcome to Voice Acting 101. Today's episode, we're going to discuss some of the basics of what you need to get to help your voice acting office look great. We're going to be talking about your equipment. The first and easiest guess is the microphone. The most common you'll see and used in voiceovers are condenser microphones. They usually have larger diaphragms built in to capture the nuance of your voice more for clearer and precise recordings. For beginners, the easiest setup to start with is USB condenser mics. They're easier to put together, they're budget-friendly if you're just getting started and don't have a lot of money to play with. The good USB mics I recommend are the Shure PG42 USB Edition, the Samsung CO1U Regular and Pro Edition, the Blue Yeti Regular and Pro Edition, and the Rode N USB Edition. If you do have a bigger budget to play with and want some extra firepower, you can look into XLR condenser mics, backed by USB-powered audio boards. A great one to get for solo work is the Scarlett Solo Audio Mixer, which comes with a mic to use for a time being, but if you really want some good starting out XLR mics, check out the Audio-Technica AT2020, the Blue Spark, or the MXL990. Or if you're looking for some advanced or actually building your own home studio, look into the Neumann series, which I have been using for the past year and have really enjoyed, the Shure SM7B, or the Studio Projects mic series. I've also been told that the Sennheiser MKH shotgun mic does a really good job for voiceovers too, so check that one out. Moving on to the next phase, you're gonna be looking at recording software. And the easiest free one would be Audacity, but it is a little limited in what it can do. Not to mention it crashes a lot. Luckily, Pro Tools has launched a free version of their software called Pro Tools 1. I recommend it because it produces really high quality recordings and is super awesome for post effects. Mac users actually got pretty lucky because they have access to a free great recording software called GarageBand, which is a multi-lined recording system that mixes voice with music and instrumentals.
Which is also pretty great for singers starting out as well. You should probably look into that, write that one down.
One big thing to consider when you're recording is where you'll be doing it. Ideally, it's best to be recording in an isolated and soft padded area to ensure clear recordings free of larger amounts of echoing, which is why most studios, homemade or professional, tend to look like this. If you're low on funds to buy studio foam, which you should absolutely buy when you can, I have been told that foam egg cartons, bed padding, and blankets make for decent substitutes in reducing echo, but foam all the way, get it when you can. Also look into shock mounts, pop filters, and boom mic stands when setting up your recording space. Shock mounts act as a little metal nest to hold your mic in to reduce rumble and noise if you ever need to move or the mic needs to move, or if you accidentally hit the mic.
But try not to hit the mic, it's very sensitive.
Pop filters cut the harshness of saying words that start with some hard consonants like P or B, and just reduce the wind force of your voice when recording. And boom mic stands, while they aren't vital, I think they help more when working with script stands. So that way the mic can be hovered in front of you with the script below so it's easier to read and record. And on a personal note, it is best to record 6 inches in front of your mic to fully capture the nuance of your vocals. You might have to take a few little inches back when you're yelling, but if you can make it work, keep it at 6 inches. Now, I know it's a pain to budget and you have to spend a bunch to get started on this job, but the quality of your recordings will ensure you'll be considered for more auditions and perhaps in the future, more bookings. Thank you so much for listening in. Tune in next time where we discuss a very critical subject that I have been requested to discuss a lot, and that is handling criticism. This is PM Seymour, signing out.